The concept of virtual water refers to the practice of trading commodities which themselves contain water. It's not always easy to trade water from one country to another. For one thing, the water itself may be difficult to transport in large quantities. Furthermore, there may be political obstacles when one country sells its water supply to another country. Domestic citizens don't always like that. But then, think about wheat. Wheat contains water. For instance, it can be that up to 1,300 liters of water go into growing a kilogram of wheat. So if one country is trading wheat to another country, in essence, that country is also trading water. In the Middle East, some countries have much more water than others. For instance, Lebanon is a relatively water-rich country by the standards of the region. So ideally, Lebanon could be trading more of its water resources to other Middle Eastern countries in the form of agricultural products. This doesn't always happen, of course, because there is not free trade in the region, and many countries in the region prefer to be self-sufficient. Of course, this desire for self-sufficiency is usually backed very strongly by the domestic agricultural lobbies. The bottom line is this: sometimes the most efficient way to trade water is to trade it in the form of a tomato.